सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तमा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदधाति पूर्वं ये वेदागश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुंह देवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्री चिद्घन गणेश नमो मह्यम सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धिर्दृक् पारं सर्व वेदांत तदेव हनुमत्वं तिमि निश्चिता मतिः। ओके सो कंटिन्यूइंग द चतुर्थ स्तरंगः वी लुक्ड एट द टिप्पणा टू मुख्य सामानाधिकरण्यम। वी लुक्ड एट द टू टाइप्स ऑफ सामानाधिकरण इन द टिप्पणा एंड कमिंग बैक टू द मूल यथा घटाकाश महाकाशयोर अभेद सर्वदा सिद्धः तद्वत् कूटस्थस्य सर्वदा ब्रह्मणा सह अभेदः सिद्ध एव। Thereby, anena hetuna, because just like Mahakasha is itself called as Ghatakasha, meaning Ghatakasha is never different from Mahakasha. Therefore, similar to that, Kutastha being Brahma, never separate, always Brahma. Therefore, anena hetuna, that is the hetu. कूटस्थस्य ब्रह्मणः मुख्य सामानादि बिकॉज ऑफ दैट रीजन व्हेन जीव ब्रह्मैव न परः इज सेड देयर जीव मीन्स कूटस्थ एंड कूटस्थ इज नेवर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ब्रह्म। फर्दर वेदांत शास्त्रेषु अभिधीयते इट इज सेड वेदांत शास्त्रेषु अभिधीयते and it is explained why it is so in contrast to bada samanadikaranyam. In the earlier class we saw the bada samanadikaranyam in the tippana, but the sadhu has not explained in the mula yet. Here he says anena eva hetuna kutasthasya brahmana sa mukhya samanadikaranyam vedanta shastreshu abhidiyate. And what is mukhya samanadikaranyam? Yasya vastunaha yena vastuna saha sada abheda sambandhosti tasya vastunaha tena vastuna sa mukhya samanadikaranyam uchyate. Whichever thing, whichever pada, we can say pada and padartha there. So whichever vastu, it represents a padartha. So whichever vastu has abheda with the other vastu all the time. Here the padartha is same, but padas are different. So yasta vastunaha yena vastunasa. Here we think that ghatakasha is a different vastu, mahakasha is a different vastu, kutastha is a different vastu, and brahma is a different vastu. This is the buddhigata misunderstanding. But in reality, they are never different. So abheda sambandha. What is abheda sambandha? There is no sambandha possible at all. Abheda sambandha means they are never different. Sambandha is figurative. Between Kutastha and Chaitanya, there cannot be a sambandha at all because Kutastha is Brahma. There cannot be a Kutastha and Brahma sambandha. But Abheda sambandha is figurative there, meaning Abheda asti. Then they both are said to be in Mukhya Samanadikaranya. यथा घटाकाशस्य महाकाशेन सह सदा अभेदस्य सत्वात् घटाकाशो महाकाशे एव तस्माद् घटाकाशस्य महाकाशेन सह मुख्य सामानाधिकरणं भवति। यू सीन दिस इन द टिप्पणा आई नीड नॉट एक्सप्लेन अगेन। Mahakasha being Ghatakasha, meaning literally here in the Sadhu Vachana in the Mula, Ghatakasha never being different from Mahakasha, or Ghatakasha having Abheda with Mahakasha all the time. Therefore, both are in Mukhya Samanadikaranam. Itham Kutastha Brahmano Sada Abhedasya Sattva. Kutasthasya Brahmanasa Mukhya Samanadikaranam Bhavati. And similarly, Kutastha and Brahma have Abheda all the while, even in the Baddhavastha, when Kutastha Jiva misunderstands himself as Chidabhasa, even then Kutastha is always one with Chaitanya. Chidabhasa being Mithya, this Jiva who considers himself as Chidabhasa and actually thereby claims Jivatvam, that Jivatvam is Mithya. Jiva by Swarupa is Kutastha, and even in the Baddhavastha, the Jiva is really Mukta. Jivatvam brings him samsara, but Kutasthatvam, Chaitanyatvam, Shuddha Chaitanyatvam will free him, which is figurative freedom because he was ever free. As we have seen, the monkey which holds a fruit in a small neck pot is unable to pull the hand out and cries that it is stuck. This is our case. We are holding on to samsara. By holding on to our jivatva bhava, individuality, kartrutva, bhoktrutva, thereby wanting the phala, like the monkey wants the phala in the ghata, which has a very small neck, where the hand can go in, but the fist cannot come out with the fruit. As soon as the monkey drops the fruit, it is free. Was it free? It was always free. With the phalecha, the monkey was bound. This is our monkey mind. With the phalecha, it binds us. And jivatva bhava is mithya, jiva kutasthatvena satyam. Tasmad ahamiti shabdabodhyasya kutasthasya brahmanasa sada abheda eva aste. Kutastha is always Brahma, and therefore with Mukhya Samanadikaranyam, if one inquires into Kutastha Swarupa, it is Brahma. If Chidabhasa is inquired into, then Chidabhasa can be seen two ways. Chidabhasa does not have existence other than Chaitanya, Brahma Chaitanya, Kutastha, any word you can use. Therefore, Chidabhasa is nothing but Kutastha. That is one way to look at it. But Kutastha is not Chidabhasa. Chidabhasa is Kutastha, but Kutastha is not Chidabhasa, because Kutastha is wider, not limited to Chidabhasa. The snake is rope, but the rope is not snake, because rope can appear not only as snake, it can appear as Bhuchidra, Danda, Ityadi, Tailadhara, Jaladhara. Many manifestations of rope are possible. All misunderstandings, but none of them are different from rope. Rope is not any one of them. Similarly, Kutastha Brahma is appearing as others. Therefore, others, meaning Jivas, are not different from Kutastha Brahma, but Kutastha Brahma is not limited to any one of them. That is the Satya Mithya Sambandha. And thereby, whenever Jagat, which is the Sharira that causes Sukshma Sharira, Stula Sharira, Non-Sharira, Insentient Prapancha, all of those sentient and insentient bodies, they are all equated to Brahma by Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma. But when that equation is done, that time we have to understand it is not Mukhya Samanadikaranyam, because Kutastha and Brahma works both ways. Kutastha is Brahma, Brahma is Kutastha. But the equation does not work the same with the Prapancha or the Sharira or Chidabhasa also, which is the effect of reflection of the ब्रह्म और कूटस्थ तत्व इन दि शरीर शरीर त्रय ऑल्सो बट वी कैन टेक बुद्धि और अविद्या कारण शरीर मेन सूक्ष्म शरीर लूजली मेंशन एंड देर इज ऑल्सो इन दि स्थूल शरीर देर इज आइडेंटिफिकेशन विच इट सेल्फ इज प्रतिबिंब सो दैट क्लोजेस दिस मुख्य सामानाधिकरण नाउ व्हाट इज दिस बाद सामानाधिकरण इन मूल अहम इति शब्देन प्रतिभासमान चिदाभासस्य तु ब्रह्मणा सह स्वस्वरूप बाधपूर्वकम् एव अभेदः सिध्यति व्हेन यू इक्वेट द प्रपंच विथ ब्रह्म ड्यू टू श्रुति वाक्य सर्वं खल्विदं ब्रह्म इदं जगत् सर्वं और दैट सर्वं विच वी डू नॉट अंडरस्टैंड एज हैविंग द शरीरत्रय आल्सो दैट इज व्हाई व्हेन जीवा इज इक्वेटेड विथ ब्रह्म शरीरत्रय हैज ऑल is already prapancha shariratraya is not really jiva a part of jagat is claimed as sharira we associate with a part of jagat this entire sharira including the mind and sense organs with the sthula sthula sukshma and karana sharira is very subtle but if, even if you just consider the sthula and sukshma sharira they are part of jagat And Chidabhasa is also part of Jagat because it has come up, has a birth. Whatever is having a Janma, whatever has Janmadi Vikara is all born and part of Prapancha. Thereby, when they are equated, even in the Jiva Pada, when the equation works, the Jagat component has to be discarded as Mithya. अहम इति शब्देन प्रतिभासमान चिदाभासस्य तु वी सी दैट अहम अहम इज ऑलवेज इनिशियली कंसिडर्ड एज द आइडेंटिफाइड चिदाभास विद द शरीर ऑल्सो बट देन अहम ऑल्सो हैज अनदर मीनिंग ऑफ कूटस्थ अहम परवेड्स थ्रू एंड थ्रू फ्रॉम द आउटर मोस्ट कोशा टू द इनर मोस्ट कोशा बिकॉज First, we consider as when I say aham, stulaha, or you know, whatever, aham shvetaha, shvetavarna, aha, all these ideas which are there, they are of the annamaya kosha. So, starting outwards from the annamaya kosha, where there is aham bhavaha, identification, that is erroneous. Therefore, from the अन्नमय कोशः आत्मा फ्रॉम देयर वी गो टू तस्माद् वा एतस्माद् कंपेयर टू दैट अन्नमय कोश देयर इज समथिंग इंटीरियर दैट हैपेंस टू बी आत्मा सो प्राणमय बिकम्स आत्मा अन्नमय बिकम्स अ कोश सो अहम भाव हैज शिफ्टेड फ्रॉम अन्नमय कोश टू प्राणमय कोश एंड देन फर्दर विद इन ईच एंड एवरी आत्मा मिसअंडरस्टूड एज अहम Atma is separated out as kosha and we land on inner. When we can go no further, that is the real Atma. Pratyagatma, sa kashta sa paragatihi. That is the innermost. There cannot be any further travel cognitively. So aham pada goes all the way. From outermost kosha to innermost kosha, outermost kosha and innermost kosha, all these koshas are really prapancha. Thereby, even if aham iti shabdena pratibhasamana chidabhasa is there, tasya chidabhasa situ brahmanasa swaswarupa badapurvakam eva abheda siddhyati. Even if you equate it, sarvam khalvidam brahma or jiva brahma, where jivatva includes nama rupatmaka, कोश पंचकोशात्मक शरीर त्रय और शरीर त्रयात्मक जीव नाम रूप पंचकोश एंड शरीर त्रय शुड बी निगेटेड स्वस्वरूप बाधपूर्वकम इफ यू इंक्वायर इन टू देर स्वरूप दे आर मिथ्या देर फोर अभेदः स्वरूप बाधपूर्वकम् एव सिध्यति You have to negate, otherwise oneness is not possible between them. Oneness is possible by negating them. How? You don't need anything on the left side. When you say Sarvam Brahma, Panchakoshas are Brahma, Shariratraya are Brahma, then Shariratraya is Brahma, then Shariratrayam Nasti, Brahma Evasti. Jagan Nasti, Brahma Evasti. Panchakosha Nasanti, Panchakosha Nasanti, Kutastha Brahma Eva Asmi finally. Asti, Paroksha Jnana, and then Aparoksha Jnana is Asmi. And that is called as Badhayam Samanadikaranam. Tasmad Vedanta Shastreshu Abhasasya Brahmanasa Badhayam Samanadikaranyam Eva Uchyate. Because Badha, Badha Purvakam Samanadikaranyam is Badhayam Samanadikaranyam. Yasya Vastuna Swaswarupa Nasha Purvakam Yena Vastunasa Abhedo Jayate Tasya Vastuna Stena Vastunasa Badhayam Samanadikaranyam Uchyate. So here the definition is given. Whichever Vastu earlier, Sada, Yatra, Sada, not Yatra, Yatra is fine, but Yayoho, for clarity, it is Dvivachana. Yayoho, Sada Abheda Siddhyati, Sada Abheda Vartate. Between the two, if there is Abheda all the time, then that is Mukhya Samanadikaranyam. But then, Yayoho Samanadikaranyam, Vada Purvakemeva Siddhyati. Tayoho Badhayam Samanadikaranyam Vartate. Tayoho Madhi. So Yasya Vastuna Swarupa Nasha Purvakam. Swarupa Nasha Purvakam is Badha. Cognitively, you have to negate their existence, and then only you can say that both these padas are same. Meaning, the earlier pada being a name for being a pada for padartha which is mithya, therefore mithya padartha nasti, thereby the padam has samanadikaranam with brahma pada, with the right hand side. So samanadikaranam between padas are possible only when you negate the padartha on one side as mithya, then the Pada Samanadikaranyam is valid. That is how the padartha, ekaha padartha nasti, anya eva vartate. Anya eva satyam. That is Samanadikaranyam in Bada Samanadikaranyam. Yatha mukha pratibimbasya swarupa bada purvakam mukharupa bimbena abhedasya drishtatvat pratibimbo mukham eva na anyata. So pratibimba is none other than mukha when the pratibimba reflection is seen in the mirror, in the darpana, then mukha is bimba, and pratibimba seen, the face seen in the mirror, which is a pratibimba, that is nothing but mukha. How so? Is it really the mukha as it is? Can you wash the mirror, the face in the mirror, and will your face be clean? No. So badhayam samanadikaranam. Mukha pratibimbasya swarupa bada purvakameva. You have to do swarupa bada there, meaning pratibimbita mukham nasti, mama mukham eva vartate. Swarupa bada purvaka mukharupa bimbena abhedasya drishtatva. We have seen this, as everyone has an experience that nobody, unless you are really sleepy, nobody will, put a bindi or put a kumkuma on the jarpana gata mukha. You put on your mukha. You look at the mirror to decorate or ornament yourself, clean your face. You look at the mirror, but you don't clean the face in the mirror. You may clean the mirror, but not the face in the mirror. It is very straightforward. There is no doubt in that case. And similarly, here also we should not have any doubt that Chidabhasa or Shariratraya or Jagat, when it is equated, here I am extending that to Jagat because we'll look at Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma also should be understood in this manner. It is an extension. In the context, it is not applicable. But I want you to remember this. Whenever Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma, people will keep on talking about this. We also may have doubts. No, Jagat and Brahma are one. the same way that Jiva and Brahma are one. It is not so. Otherwise, Bhagavan Bhashyakara, Bhagavat Padacharya would never have said Jiva Brahmaiva Napara only. He would have stopped at that. Or Sarvam Brahma. Shruti would have stopped at that. But Bhagavan Bhashyakara, when he says, Shlokardhena Pravakshyami Yaduktam Grantha Koti Vihi Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya Jiva Brahmaiva Napara. Jagat has been said to be mithya. Jagat mithya and idam sarvam jagat khalu brahma eva. They do not go together. If they have to go together, though, how do they go together? Because jagan mithya. Jagat is not brahma. When you say jagat is brahma, badhayam samanari karanyam jagan mithyatvena nasti and brahma eva asti. That is the understood meaning. That is the concluded meaning in the analysis of Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma. Bada Samanadikari. Unlike Jiva Brahma Ivanapara. Jiva Brahma Ivanapara, their Kutastha Jivaha Brahma Eva. By Mukhya Samanadikari. But then if you take Chidabhasa Jiva, which is what people misunderstand, their Chidabhasa Jivaha has Bada Samanadikari with Brahma. But Kutastha, and we have seen there, Chidabhasa has jnana, aikya jnana. How? Not mama adhisthana. The way Tattva Drishti proposed a solution, because I see these issues, I think this is the solution. He offered a solution saying that the jnanotpatti is not aham brahma, but mama adhisthana kutastha chaitanyam brahma. That is paroksha jnana. That is not how the jnana takes place. Jnana should take place as aham, yaha aham chidabhasaha saha mithya, yaha aham kutastha chaitanyam saha brahma or tad brahma by videh pradhanam. So brahma eva asmi, that should be the jnana, and that is how it takes place for chidabhasa alone, but by Badha of Chidabhasa and Badha of Chidabhasa, but Brahma Pada is there, which is Kutastha. Kutastha Badha can never happen. Sakashta, Sa Paragati, which can never be negated. One who remains after negating anything and everything, that me is Brahma. Yathava Stano Purusha Brahmanantaram Vichara Stanutvena Jnane Sati Purusha Stanureva Iti Purushasya Stanuna Saha Badhayamiva Samanadikarnyam Jayate Tatha Abhasasyapi Badhanantaram Eva Brahmanasa Abheda Sambhavati. We have seen this example. Purusha Stanureva. There Purusha is Stanu. You have to understand that the Chauraha was Stanu. The person that there was an abhasa of, that somebody is following me, that is nothing but the stump. But then there, so when you say Purusha Stanureva, that time Purushaha Nasti, Chauraha Nasti, Stanureva Asti. So this, there is only a stump, but there is no Purusha at all. It is an insentient thing. So Purushaha Stanureva is Bada Samanavikar. And similarly, the earlier, earlier we saw. So, Stanunasa Badhayam Eva Samanadikarnim Jayate Tatha. Similarly, Abhasasyapi Badhanantaram Eva Brahmanasa Abheda Sambhavati. So, Chidabhasa Rupa Aham Na Asmi. Meaning, Aham Chidabhasa Rupena Na Asmi Mithyatvena Hetuna. Then, what am I really? I am Kutastha. Therefore, Kutastha Sarupena Aham Brahma Eva Tatra Mukhya Samanadikarnim. And in Chidabhasa Rupa, there is Bada Samanadikarnim. We have seen the Tippana. Moving on. Tasmad. Therefore, in conclusion, Tasmad aham iti shabda bodhyabhaso brahmaiva na tato anyaha. Therefore, aham. What does aham really reveal? I am that aham shabda. Aham iti shabda bodhya abhasa. Chidabhasa, which is revealed by aham, is brahma. By badha samananiko na tato anyaha. There is no separate existence for Chidabhasa. Abhasasya Brahmanasa Idrisha Vadhayam Samanadikarnim Sambhavati. So Abhasa can have jnana, aham brahmasmi, which is the doubt of Purva Pakshi as mithya. We say yes, it is mithya. but it will give real results. How? Badhayam. Badhayam. Ekam eva chaitanyam vartate tattvamasi. That you are. That chaitanyam. Where? All the mithya or contradictory components have been refuted, have been negated. What remains is the substratum, which cannot be different, the chaitanya, which is your own swarupa. Ittham eva aham iti shabdagamyasya kutasthasya brahmanasa mukhyabheda abhasasya tu badhayam abheda iti janihi. So you understand this, says the guru to tattva drishti, as mukhya abheda and badha abheda have to be understood. So samana adhikaranyam leads to abheda. And what is this abheda? Mukhya abheda or badha abheda? So badhayam abheda in the case of chidabhasa equated to Brahma, and by extension we saw jagad also. And mukhya abheda is only when kutastha, you land on your own swarupa as kutastha, that is never different from Brahma. Meaning it is one. Ekam evad vitiyam Brahma asmi. That is the jnana possible for abhasa. By negating the jivatva bhava abhasatvam. And then pratibimbatvam negated. Abhasatvam negated. Jivatva bhava. Jivatvam negated. What remains is kutastha, who is none other than Brahma. This jnana is possible only for chidabhasa, never for kutastha, because kutastha is avikari. Chidabhasa has vikara. Jnana comes up, resolves the chidabhasa also. What remains through neti neti prakriya is shuddha chaitanya. Kutastha abhasyo amvruttav bhanam kim kramena uta kramam vina iti vicharaha. Now there is a vichara related to kutastha and abhasa. You say that aham. When you say aham, whenever you say anything, aham is there. Khadami. Aham is sitting there. Even if you don't utter aham, aham is there. Because khadami cannot have any other purusha, has to be uttama purusha. Now if you say, you are talking with someone else. If this is a statement, aham is still there. How? Although there is Madhyama Purusha, still you are the witness to it, because you are making a statement. If you are making a statement, there you are witness to, say, Chaitraha talking to Maitraha. So Chaitraha talking to Maitraha is known in the statement uttered by me. That utterance needs me, aham. In the Prathama Purusha also, if I say, you know, there Chaitraha, Chaitra and Maitra can be the Prathama Purusha example. If I say you are talking to Maitraha, then there is Madhyama Purusha. So even in the case of Madhyama Purusha and Prathama Purusha, aham is there. Without aham, there is no transaction possible. Any transaction, whether the Uttama Purusha is involved or not in the sentence construct, still the Uttama Purusha, being Purushottamaha, is always there. Who is the Kutastha? Chaitanya. So Kutastha Abhasayo Aham Vrittav Bhanam. When I say Aham, then Kutastha Aham as well as Chidabhasa Aham, both can be the meanings. Which is the meaning? Guru said that you as Chidabhasa, how? You meaning Tvam, who says Aham. Aham Chidabhasaha Brahma. That time when that jnana takes place, then Chidabhasa and Brahma have Badha Samanadi Karanyam. And by Badha you have landed on Brahma Tattva, which is Kutastha Tattva. So there is Mukhya Samanadi Karan there. So when you land on Kutastha, there is Mukhya Samanadi Karanyam. And when you remain with Abhasa, there is Badha Samanadi Karanyam. So Aham has Chidabhasa meaning as well as Kutastha. Now in this Aham Vritti, because Aham is expressed in the Vritti itself, when Aham Vritti takes place, in that Aham Vritti, Chidabhasa and Kutastha Bhana, that I am Chidabhasa or I am Kutastha, they are opposed. I am Chidabhasa or I am Kutastha. Am I both? But I am both as well. So this is how mithya works. Mithya will not let you conclude anything, because antakarana will keep on raising doubts. That is mithya. The avarana and vikshepa shakti is so strong, you cannot decide satya or asat. Asatyam, sat or asat, you cannot decide. Therefore, mithya is somewhere in between. Sadasadhyam anirvachani. It is different from sat, different from asat. So when this in aham vritti you want to decide, no, what exactly is this aham vritti? Is it kutastha or chidabhasa? There also this mithya works in such a manner. The vritti is mithya. Vritti being mithya, it does not let you conclude one way or the other, idam ittham. Therefore, the question is, kutastha, aham means kutastha, aham means abhasa also, whether both occur together or they occur in a sequence. Aham vrittav bhanam kim kramena uta kramam vina iti vichara. Is there a sequence or not to this kutastha and abhasa being revealed in aham vritti? So prashna is asked there by tattva drishti. Hey swamin, to the guru, O swami, aham vrittav sakshi chidabhasayo pratibhanam bhavati iti bhavata uktam. You have said that in aham vritti, sakshi kutastha. Sakshi is another name for kutastha chaitanya. And chidabhasa, another name is pratibhimba. So sakshi and chidabhasa, or kutastha and chidabhasa, bhana, their bhana is there in aham vritti. You have mentioned this. Now, tatra kim tayor yugapat pratitir jayate uta kala bhedeniti me samshya. So, I have a doubt, he says, is there a pratiti there? Do I understand this aham as kutastha and chidabhasa together, or do I have a sequence? Is there a sequence to this understanding? I am unable to decide what exactly is happening. Because it is so fast, I have absolutely no way to even differentiate. In Viveka, sometimes the differentiation becomes hard. For example, when you wake up, anyone wakes up. As soon as you wake up, the mind is active. I start planning the day. I think back as to what was left out yesterday. Or what do I have to do today? What is the panchanga today? Which tithi is there? What do I need to do? Which vara? All this comes to the forefront. Or, oh, did I wake up in time or late? Do I need tea now? Do I need the bath immediately? Do I have to go out? All this comes up as soon as, all, not all this, any of this or other things comes up. Any of this or other thing comes up in the mind as soon as the mind wakes up. That is when I wake up. When I wake up as Chidabhasa, everything is so simultaneous, it is difficult for me to differentiate. Oh, I am a father, I am an engineer. All of this comes to the forefront so soon that it is difficult to separate out the kutastha me, who stands as a sakshi to all these events. I become one with it. I become one with this. Oh, I have a class to teach. I have a class to attend. I am already late for it. When will I do my... All these ideas just pop up in the mind, but they are in the mind. Chidabhasa is associated with it. Chidabhasa has woken up. And Chidabhasa finds it difficult to inquire and land on kutastha swarupatvam. Therefore, whether it is together or kramena, tattva drishti is unable to decide. So, iti me samshayaha tan me bhavan vispashtam bodhayatu. Please clarify this, says tattva drishti. He requests to the guru. Pura prashnasya uttaram. What is the answer there? Aham vrittav sakshi chidabhasayor yugapad bhanam. So, one good thing is that sadhu does not keep the question lingering on, because, you know, the students go on a tangent. Oh, what exactly is happening here? Nothing wrong there. The student also has to think. But he favors us a little by telling us what is the tattva. Then he goes into the analysis, how so? So this is like in Bhashya, those who have studied Bhashya, there is a sangraha vakya. So this is like a sangraha vakya. Aham vruttau sakshi chidabhasayor yugapat bhanam. How so? Then that is elaborated in the bhashya. So in the aham vritti, sakshi kutastha and chidabhasa appear together. The understanding is together. They in aham vritti itself, both are sitting together. He somya vispashtam sarataram uttaram uchyate. Says clearly, I'll tell you as you have requested. And what is this answer? It is not only clear, it is saratama. It is the essence of every teaching that we have seen so far. It is the answer is saratama. It is an essence, but it is the complete essence. It is not partial. You don't have to think further on this question. This is the kind of clarity I'll give you, says the guru there. Shrunu Savadhana Manaha. So Savadhana Manaha is a Bahurihi and it is Prathama Ekvachana. So Savadhana Manas is the Pratipadika. It will be Sakaranta. Therefore, Savadhana Manaha San, not plural, singular. Savadhana Manaha San Tvam Shrunu. You listen to it with an attentive mind. Etat Shravana Janya Jnana Surya Prakashode Matrena Gadha Jnana Rupatamo Nishesham Vinakshanti. Vinakshati. So there was an alarm, so I got distracted. Etat Shravana Janya Jnana Surya Prakashode Matrena Gadha Jnana Rupatamo Nishesham Vinakshati. Vishesha Rupena Nangshati. Ritlakara. It will definitely go away. What will go away? Tamaha, ajnana rupa tamaha. Tamaha, which is ajnana. And what kind of ajnana? Like gada tama, it is gada ajnana. It is that which has kept us in samsara. That will go away nishesham. Completely it will go away without anything remaining. How? Etat shravana janya jnana surya prakasha udaya matrena. Just by listening to this attentively, of course, and Shravana is also Vicharatmaka. Therefore, Shravana will lead to Jnana, and that Jnana is comparable to Surya Prakasha. And Tasya Jnana Udayena, Jnana Udaya Matrena, just like Surya Prakasha Udaya Matrena, Tamaha goes away. Similarly, Jnana Udayena. Jnana Udaya Matrena Ajnanamapi Vinangshati will go away. Completely. He Shishya Sakshabhasav Ubhav Api Aham Vrittav Yugapadeva Pratiyete. Both Sakshi meaning Kutastha Chaitanya and Abhasa meaning Chidabhasa or Pratibimba, both are apparent in Aham Vritti together. Simultaneously both are there. That is why only a cognitive shift will do. Just understanding that I am not Chidabhasa, I am Kutastha, both being mixed up. If I can separate out by understanding, that is sufficient. Vedanta Prakaraneshu Sarvatra Abhasa Iti Shabdena Antakkarana Sahita Chidabhasa Yudrahiyaha. Antakkarana sahita chidabhasa eva grahyaha Vedanta prakaraneshu. In all the prakarana granthas, Vedanta. So Vedanta and prakarana grantha. Vedanta can mean Upanishad and prakarana grantha. Everywhere, wherever abhasa is used. Abhasa iti shabdena antakkarana sahita chidabhasa eva grahya. Antakkarana is there and abhasa is with antakkarana. Antakkarana sahita chidabhasa sakshino vishayataya bhati. For the sakshi, saksha kim, saksham kim, saksham is chidabhasa. That is why I can witness the changing me, the planning waker. When chidabhasa wakes up and starts planning the day out, although it is difficult, it is possible that my mind to inquire and differentiate, discriminate that mind is active. I have suddenly become the planner. I can see the planner. I can see the planner vritti in my mind. Aham vritti has this planner who is thinking what to do of this day now. Should I sleep more? Should I wake up? Should I snooze the alarm further? Or take a bath and get going with the day? That Chidabhasa who is woken up with the mind, because the mind has woken up, Chaitanya ever existent has started reflecting in the mind and revealing itself. The mind is revealed, so is Chidabhasa revealed. That Chidabhasa who is revealed to the Sakshi. Who can, so the Sakshi is a witness to Chidabhasa. Again, to differentiate, there is a mind needed, there is a buddhi needed, there is aham vritti needed, where there is again Chidabhasa. So Chidabhasa, the aham vritti keeps on popping up and there is analysis possible, which is all at the Chidabhasa level. Sakshi Shuddha Chaitanya Kutastha is separate. That is my real Swarupa, because I know each and every Chidabhasa. I may have given this example earlier, but if you are doing japa, for example, you are doing japa of some mantra or some shloka chanting, whatever it is, you know, Vishnu Sahasranama, Gita, whatever you are chanting, when you are doing that point of time, if the mind wavers, the japa continues, and if you are reading or you are, it is kantastha to you, you are chanting, the chanting continues. If you are reading, the reading continues, chanting continues, even during the class continues. Your mind is elsewhere. Now, when the mind is elsewhere, suddenly you think that, oh, I have not been attentive. So you bring back the mind and then start to see where was your chant. Sometimes we miss it. Sometimes we know that chanting is continuing. Now, if the chanting is continuing, while I am thinking of something else, my mind is elsewhere. So I am planning something else. What should I do after this chant? After my sandhya is over, what should I do? There is another thought there where aham vritti is there. Aham vritti is also there in chanting. And then I have brought back the mind. Oh, my mind is elsewhere. Chanting is going on. I should focus here. So I bring that mind. There is a third so-called entity which has popped up. Who is inquiring now at a very subtle level? How can I be chanting and elsewhere at the same time? Then the third who has popped up, who is inquiring into these two, is known to me. So that another is spun off. There is a third who is spun off. Oh, I am a witness to even that thought or the thinker who is inquiring into the chanter and the person who has wavered away, who has gone elsewhere planning the day. So how many entities are really there? Something, as soon as I inquire into it, I have objectified it and then is separated. That I is separated out. That I cannot be the real I because of the very reason of my objectifying it. Drishyatvat mithya. As soon as I inquire, and this is a meditative activity also. Gave a chanting example because this was an anubhava long back, you know, in childhood I was chanting and then I used to think, how can there be so many, you know, so many spun off me's? Who is the real me? If you look at it, everything is going simultaneously, but then who is the real me among this? It is very mind boggling if you start inquiring into it, especially untrained. So there aham vrittau, chidabhasa and sakshi are both there. As soon as you start inquiring, the chidabhasa is separated out. all the avatars of Chidabhasa are separated out. Chidabhasa is the one who becomes the chanter, the thinker, the planner, the inquirer, the Baddha, and the Mukta. So there, Vedanta Prakaraneshu Sarvatra Abhasa iti Shabdena Antakkarna Sahita Chidabhasa Eva Grahya Antakkarna Sahita Chidabhasa Sakshinaha Vishayataya Bhati. There is a pratiti of Chidabhasa. How? In Aham Vritti. As the Vishaya of Sakshi. So Sakshi and Chidabhasa are together in Aham Vritti, but Sakshi Kutastha, that's why Sakshi has been used here. Kutastha Chaitanya is also called as Sakshi, but why did he not use Kutastha Chaitanya? Because he wants to show that Chidabhasa is Sakshya in the Aham Vritti and therefore not my real Swarupa, whereas Kutastha is my real Swarupa because I am Sakshi who is Avikari. Sakshi is not involved in the crime or in the any activity that that deserves a reward. Any rewarding activity or a criminal activity, in the case of Sakshi, Sakshi is a word used as a witness. So if there is something going on, generally in the Sakshi is called in the court because of criminal activity. So somebody is doing a criminal activity, Sakshi standing there is not part of the crime. He is separate, Shuddha, untainted by the crime. That is only when Sakshi is untainted by the crime, then alone the Sakshi is a real Sakshi. He has nothing to do with either parties. Then alone, he is a valid witness. That kind of Sakshi me has Vishaya as Chidabhasa. Who does Punya Papa? Sakshi tu Swayam Prakashataya Bhati. So in the Aham Vritti, Sakshi shines forth by its own Prakasha. By my own Prakasha, I shine forth because I am Chaitanya Rupa. Chidabhasa Sahita Antakkarna Vritya na Sakshi Vishayi Kriyate. Chidabhasa shines forth only after Sakshi shining forth. After in the sense, only, rather instead of putting a Krama, only because the Sakshi is there, therefore this Vishayatvena or Vishayataya Chidabhasa Pratitihi Vartate. Chidabhasa Sahita Antakkarna Vritya. Through the Vritti, which is in the Antakkarna, Buddhi Vritti, where Chidabhasa is there. So Chidabhasa Sahita Antakkarna Vritti. In the Antakkarna Vritti, Chidabhasa is also there. Chaitanya is also there. Kutastha Chaitanya Sakshi. Chidabhasa is Sakshya. And Vritti is also Sakshya. The Sakshya Vritti and Sakshya Chidabhasa for the Sakshi cannot make Chaitanya or Sakshi as the Vishaya. Therefore, Sakshi Vritya na Vishayi Kriyate. The Vritti cannot objectify Sakshi. Sakshi objectifies the Vritti and Chidabhasa also. Chidabhasa, which is there in the Vritti, even if Chidabhasa is there, which makes the Vritti sentient by having the Abhasa of Chaitanya, cannot objectify Sakshi. So that is the background as to in Aham Vritti, rather the details of Aham Vritti. Aham Vritti has both Chidabhasa and Sakshi, Kutastha, but Sakshi is Swayam Prakasha and has Chidabhasa as a Vishaya. Therefore, Vishaya and Vishayi are together. They don't have any Krama. Vishaya and Vishayi are together. Sakshya and Sakshi are together. Sakshya cannot have Sakshi as Vishaya. Sakshi has Sakshya as Vishaya. We'll stop here. We'll continue with Ghatadi Bahya Padartha Jnanotpatti Kramaha Tu Evam. in the case of objectification of ghatapatadi prapancha, what happens there? Sadhu goes back to the Vedanta's theory of perception, and then he'll compare that to what is happening here. That is a contrast there. So we'll look at that and come back to Tattva Drishti's question, which is being answered by Sadhu. Sukham Nityam Swaprakasham Vyapakam Nama Rupa Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddher Drukyatna Nirna Param Sarva Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Paramah Tadeva Annamatvam Yatme Nishchitamatihi Om Tat Sat. I don't have time for questions. Anyway, I keep on forgetting that Mamara thing. We'll look at it in the next part, if I recall. During the part, I recall. So if someone has answers, I got some answers. But if somebody has more to say about Mamara, it is quite simple. Everyone has complicated in the exemplified, almost everyone. Just the example, why lit lakara has been used, if we inquire, it fits in the context also. We'll have a look at it. Namaste.
Hari Om.